The ancient town of Mellowmead was destroyed by creatures known as Rhinotors. They live on still, but in a state of hibernation, deep within these caverns. They use the crystals to prolong their worthless hides.
Softly in these caves, for an ill-tempered dragon has a lair here. A mean old dragon can be summoned by inserting two dragon gems into the eye sockets of the relief. The grouchy dragon doesn't come out much, as he is afraid of the roof collapsing over his head.
To enter my lair and wake me from my slumber. Aha! Prepare yourself, little man. I shall roast the flesh from your bones. I see. Well, in that case, I will pluck out both your eyes. Oh, great. I'm just gonna give you a good hiding.
Thank you.
Take this dragon potion and leave me alone. Drink it when you need it. It gives you armor that is impervious to heat. Plus, it lets you breathe fire. Now go away.
Wouldn't this make a wonderful tourist attraction? Come see Stengard the Mighty! Come and see the last of the centaurs! Oh, and see that dork over there? That's Daniel Fortescue, would-be hero! Ha ha ha!
Daniel, there you are. I was so worried about you. I know you have the heart of a hero, Daniel. Now we must show the others. Would you like to take my magic lightning bolts? I don't have many, but they're very powerful. Off you pop, then, and keep your chin up. Oops, sorry, Daniel. Now take care. The good people of Gallimere are depending on you.
The fabled dragon armor was forged by dragons from an age long ago. Seek out any remaining dragons if you are to claim this mighty armor. Unable to pass through the fiery dragon gate? Only use this alternative route if no other is available, and return to the map of Gallimere.
Thank you.
This magical barrier was constructed by the dragons of old. Only those brave enough to adorn the dragon armor may pass through this fiery gateway.
Oh, Danielle, I've got something here I can give you, but I've no idea what it is. Do you fancy a little gamble, like?
Welcome to Castle Peregrine. In the time of King Peregrine, this magnificent edifice was the seat of power and home to the royal household. Now it is home only to ghosts and forgotten memories.
The farmers are being held in the courtyard. At the first sign of trouble, the shadow demons will sacrifice the captives to the flames. Move quickly, slay the demons on guard, and release the farmers.
Rescuing us, kind sir. Forgive us, master. We have no pig to reward you, but we'd be honored if you'd accept these shiny gold-colored stones as a token of our thanks.
Since the farmers have been captured by the shadow demons, the animals here have gone hungry. Scalding oil. Burn your skeletal toes, that will. Better find a way to close the oil vents before crossing.
Thank you.
Sir Daniel Fortescue, it's been a long time. Welcome back to your home. But it is sad that you should see it so. The jewel in Galomir's crown has become a corrupt haven for Zarak's army of shadow demons.
Long ago, this was once the majestic throne room of King Peregrine. Now foul demons stalk the corridors. Ah, the spirit of the king must be saddened indeed. The castle was constructed on top of a dormant volcano. This great floodgate is all that stands between you and a very hot shower.
Sir Fortescue, noblest of my courtiers, bravest of my captains. Oh, that we should meet at such a dark hour, with the fate of this realm lying once again in your hands. Good God, Fortescue, what's happened to your jaw? Bad luck, old man. Now look, Zarok's army of shadow demons hide beneath us within this very mountain. They prepare, as we speak, to invade fair Galomir. If we are to thwart his plans, we must bring down the castle on top. We must unleash the lava behind the floodgates. I can take you to the gate's control lever, but you alone can pull it. Of course, it's a highly dangerous mission, even for a dead man. I dare say that when that fiend sees what you've done, he'll make sure you spend eternity in the most unspeakable torment. But then, I know these things mean nothing to a man of your iron will. Eh, Fortescue? Splendid. Good luck, old friend.
The lava has been released, Sedan. The castle is collapsing. You will not have long to defeat the stone golems and escape the ensuing inferno.
The castle is about to be destroyed. The gates are locked. Find an alternative means of travel.
Well, hello, stranger. I've got a little present for you. Why don't you shut your eye and hold out your hands? Thank you.
I thought you ought to know we have a stowaway on board. I've told the men to scour the decks for him.
Good! I want that scurvy dog dangling from yon yardarm by his bowels!
Is that really necessary? Couldn't we just give him a good tongue-lashing and drop him off at the next port?
Look! There's not a man-jack on this ship who wouldn't keelhaul his own grandmother for the silver in her hair! There'll be no tongue-lashing! Bring the landlubber to me and I'll tear him a new orifice!
Most of the crew seems to be under the control of a few officers. Without them, they'd be like headless chickens.
Yeah!
ghost ship captain is as tough as old sea boots. You will need something a little more powerful than the weapons in your inventory to knock him overboard.
Fortescue. I think this is because of my shield, yeah? But I have something else I can give to you. Something you may find very interesting.